Hey guys, welcome to another draw and design tutorial. Today I am going to show you how to make a slope in a floor slab just like here. First, I ask you to please subscribe to my channel and turn on notification so you don't miss any future videos. So let's start with an architectural template. So let's quickly make a 3D model of a simple floor slab to modify using this family which we will model later in this video. So the first thing I want to do is go to create a new family and just select a generic model from the list. So we only need three parameters for this family: the length, the width, and the depth. So let's start with the width. Make a reference plane and then mark it with the aligned dimension from the insertion point to the reference plane. Select this dimension and go to label and let's label it with the width. Then check the instance which will make it dynamic and we can change the dimension on any stage. Now let's check if it works correctly. So we can change the dimension. Okay, so it works well. Now go to left or right view and make two reference planes for length and depth, just like I am doing. Then make align dimensions and label the same as we did for the width parameter. That's pretty much it. Let's do some geometry. Go to Create tab, Form panel, and choose Void Extrusion Form. Now select the Pick Line tool and pick the top and right reference plane. But make sure these are locked here, so that way you don't throw the extra dimensions. Then take Line tool and make a slope line. Then just use trim or extend tool to cut out the extra lines. So whenever I make a family, I always want to turn on the automatic sketch dimension. This one you can find in the View tab, Visibility Graphics Tools. Then use the align tool and lock the slope line to the bottom. To do so, just select the align tool and click on the reference plane, a blue dot on the corner, and then just click on the lock icon. Now close the void extrusion command and go to reference level from the project browser. do the same log procedure for the width parameter. Here comes the most important part. Go to the Properties panel and check mark the Work Plane Based and Cut with Void when Loaded options. After loading this, we'll attach the family to active work plane and cut the portion which overlaps within the model. Now go on and load this family to the floor slab project which we made earlier. Move the family to the position which you want. Now select the family and select Cut Geometry option from the Geometry panel. Click on the slab and then click on the family, which will subtract the geometry. Now that's it, the slope floor with the new family is modeled. Later on, you can change the dimensions from the Properties panel and make the desired slope and shape. Please hit like button if you like this video, give your comments in the comment section and share the video with others. Thanks for watching the video, see you in the next one.